Yeah, I'm so psyched to be here, and when people come and they want to get a picture with me or whatever, that I literally had these made. They're Doc tattoos, similar to the one I wore on the show, and I'm going to give them out to people who want to take a picture with me. I'm a nerd, too. Yeah.
I'd love to hear that. Now, I mean, have you...
In the best possible sense of the word.
Have you had much experience meeting fans at these types of events? Have you done conventions before in other places?
I did the first one last year for Showmasters, Collectomania, in Scotland, and it was a lot of fun. And I had so much fun there with the group of people that puts on the show, etc., that I decided to come back here this year and do the London Film and Comic Con. So, but these are the only two I've really done. I don't see myself doing a lot of them, quite honestly. And to be quite honest, like, I'm trying to develop a new look and try and create a new character so I can go on to play different types of parts. But I feel like Scrubs has such a cult following, and the character I played, the Todd, is so much fun to play that, you know, my enthusiasm for it spills over. And when I meet people who are so enthusiastic about the show, I just love to come out and meet them for sure.
Let's talk about the show in general, first of all. Why do you think people are so enthusiastic? What is it about Scrubs that people have loved so much? Because it is deeply beloved by people around the world.
Yes. I think that the creator of that show, his name is Bill Lawrence, and he's a gifted comedic writer who's able to alternate moments of true drama, you know, with a lot of heart, sandwiched between great comedic moments. And, you know, that's life, you know. Like, you and I could be serious one minute and funny the next. And I think that the writing of that show resonates with so many people. So I really attribute the success and the popularity of Scrubs to Bill Lawrence, the creator of the show. That's just me kissing up to the guy who may hire me again someday. A little piece of Hollywood there.
It's populated by so many fantastic characters, but the Todd is one that I think people especially have a certain affection for. What is it about the Todd that you think people love so much?
I just think that, you know, he's a lovable... He doesn't realize that he's the joke. You know, he's like, he thinks he's God's gift to women, that he's the life of the party wherever he goes, and he has no understanding how other people see him or perceive him. And I think that's really funny, that, like, that lack of awareness. And so it's so much fun. It's been so much fun for me to, you know, it was so much fun for me to play, because to play that kind of guy, like, I got to play a guy who, like, every guy kind of wishes that they could get away with and do the things he did, you know, if only society would let us. So it's interesting when I meet fans, they'll come up to me and they'll, like, you know, especially guy fans, they'll be like, you know, can I get a high five? You know, they want to spot me at the gym. But all the women always wanted to know one thing. What's Zach Braff really like? They didn't really care about me at all.
What's the answer to that question?
I have a stock answer to that. I say Zach Braff's only concern is for his partner's orgasm. He doesn't even care if he has one.
I'm glad to hear that. He's a giver.
That's a little dirty, that joke. A little cheeky. A little cheeky, that joke, huh?
A lot of cheeky.
Cheeky, yeah.
That's what you want. That's what Zach will get.
He'll give you cheeky. If you want cheeky, he'll give you cheeky. I will, too.
The Todd, he's one of those characters, he gets away with things. What was your favorite moment looking back? Is there any ones in particular you could pick out and just for, I love being able to say that, to do that, get away with?
Well, anything with Heather Graham. She guest starred on the show in season 4, and I got to do some really funny scenes with her. In fact, there was one scene I was in a hot tub with her, and it got, it's just a quick scene in the episode, but, you know, what got edited out of that was me getting out of the hot tub at the end of the scene, and I was totally naked. And we kept shooting it over and over again. And I, like, you know, Heather Graham got a real good look. And I think she liked. She said it was nice. So
method acting there. You weren't...
Method acting there. And it was big. And then my favorite moment was, like, the Miracle Five. Because I do all the different high fives. And the Miracle Five was such a great moment. Because, you know, there's always that scene in a drama where there's one doctor, like, that the patient is dead. And nobody, everybody else in the room is giving up except for the doctor. Like, I'm not giving up on this guy. And we did, like, a parody of that moment where, like, I high-fived him and it came back to life. And that, to me, is, like, you know, clever and, like, a very funny moment. So, you know, one of my funnier moments that I recall off the top of my head. Yeah.
I mean, the high-fives are beautiful. Did they ever go wrong? Did you ever accidentally, you know, clean someone's slate?
The high-five never goes wrong. It does not. I'm the architect of it. Although, Putty from Seinfeld before me and, you know, there's somebody... I brought some new energy and I reinvigorated the high five, is what I'm trying to say. But in the pilot episode of the show, I have to high-five Zach Braff, who's the star of the show. And when we did a reading for the network, all the people came, and Bill Lawrence said to me, when you go and high-five him, walk over and do it. Don't just read it, because it doesn't really translate if you read it. Oh, Todd high-fives him. So when it came up, I got up, and nobody knew that I was going to, and I came over, and I really high-fived the hell out of him. And people were laughing, but at the same time, like a little, like, oh my God, you almost killed the lead actor of the show, because it was so, and they got the idea to, like, add the whoosh, the sound effect to it, and then every high-five became really hard. And yeah, that was the first high five where I almost killed Zach Braff. And the show wouldn't have happened, by the way, if I did.
The show did run for a very long time, and fans will, of course, have their favorite episodes. I mean, you shared one of your favorite moments, but are there any particular episodes that you look back and you're very much in love with?
The musical episode was one of my favorite episodes. I was so enthusiastic to do it. I thought it was really clever and really touching and well-written, and we really worked hard rehearsing the dance sequences, and I thought it came out great. So my musical is one of my favorite, fondest memories of the show. And then there was an episode, season 5, called My Lunch, you know, where this joke about Todd, is he or isn't he gay? And that was finally addressed in season 5. And they gave me an episode called My Lunch in season 5. And I got a lot to do in that show. And I thought it came out quite nice. It was like a real, for anybody who would stick with the show for the first 5 seasons, that was a real nice payoff to a joke that we had set up for 5 seasons. So those 2 episodes, I would say.
Apart from the Todd, who's your favorite character? Who do you just love watching or working with?
I loved working with everybody, quite honestly. You know, everybody was really very friendly and generous actors. I had the most fun probably with Donald Faison, who played Turk, because we had so much to do, particularly in those early seasons when we didn't really know what Scrubs was going to be. So, yeah.
Final question.
Do you need a new sponsor? Because here I am.
What are you up to at the moment, apart from looking handsome and meeting people here in London?
I'm gray, and I'm trying to become the Cialis guy back in the States, or the Viagra guy, or both, I don't know. And I think that if I continue with this gray hair, maybe I can become the face of for adult diapers.
If they take the casting of 50 Shades of Grey literally, then you could be in there.
That's perfect. I think it's perfect. I did a movie called Hollywood that's playing right now in Paris. It was like a top 5 movie for the last 10 weeks. And I was on a show called Cougar Town this past spring. And then, you know, it'll start again this summer, and I'll just audition and, you know, look for that next job. Hopefully something as interesting, funny, and entertaining as this guy.
We're going to let you get to the fans here. But for any fans who couldn't be here, is there anything you'd like to say to all of your many, many, many fans watching this here in the UK and around the world?
To all my fans who couldn't make it this weekend, long distance 5 from the big dog.